the sunshine and the day. I'm trying to make this darkness go away. I'll paint with colors and I'll sing until my lungs give out. I'm gonna let the sun shine in the day. And I will leave my windows open so that I can hear the sound of people talking and the wind blowing in the trees. Oh, I will open up my eyes so I can see the light.
How's it going with it? I don't know. Hello. Welcome to my giant kitchen island. Welcome to my kitchen. I thought we would do something spontaneous today. I went to Costco for like 5 items and trust me, I came back with a lot more. So I want to show you what a sort of spontaneous Costco haul is like and what I only buy from Costco, why I, you know, make the effort to go there when I can go to a regular grocery store and not buy huge quantities of things. So I'm going to show you what I got. Unbox. Do you guys usually get the box? They usually offer me a box and I say no, but this time I was like, no. I don't want to carry all of these things. It's also taking a lot of self-restraint for me not to just unpack everything. So that's how much I love you guys. I just always think it's interesting, wow, I'm being like completely blunt here, to see what people buy from Costco and why. So I thought I'd share why we do it. Okay, let's start with these big guys so I can get them out of the way. Snacks. I have a love-hate relationship with snacks because I feel like they're all filled with garbage, if I'm honest. But my kids love these. The other thing is at school, like a lot of schools nowadays, they're nut-free. I don't really send these to school so much because they're so messy and like stinky, but if we needed emergency snacks, like I'm doing this as a gift to myself, I'm not gonna go and roast seaweed, and I feel like these are better than chips, pretzels, you know, like seaweed. I think it only literally, it's organic seaweed plus salt. Personally, not for me. I only eat seaweed and sushi. Whoa. But yeah, it's basically got organic seasoned seaweed snacks with sea salt. It does have some sunflower oil, but we go through these and I think it's better than the alternative. So I've got 3 of these. Then my husband wants these like protein shakes. So he better drink these because no one else is going to. But this I felt was like better than some of the others and also the smallest quantity if he didn't like them. But he's tried the vanilla and he asked me to get him some more. Yeah, I think it's important for him to get enough protein. Vanilla, and he's going to try this cafe latte flavor. So I'm sure he'll like it because he's a coffee fiend. So this is not something I buy regularly, but now we're that tennis family. So apparently, I don't ever buy tennis balls, but apparently if you see them at Costco and you need tennis balls, stock up because I think they're a really good price for the quantity. That's my understanding. And they're pen balls, which are very well respected, is my understanding. They've got the USTA League of Stamp of Approval and Djokovic on the front. So yeah, we have 2 of these, even though I feel like we're drowning in tennis balls. And what was really funny was that as I was checking out, you know, they always check your receipt when you leave. The lady was like, are these for your dog? No, lady. First of all, my dog does not have teeth and she does not need brand new pen tennis balls. You know, just saying. Like, but I'm sure there are people that buy these balls for their dogs. Okay, and then the last big items, we have salsa. We go through these a little bit too frequently, but at least they don't have sugar in them. They're kind of like a treat for my kids. We kind of have them on, we try and instill the rule of only on the weekend. Well, my husband primarily drinks these and he does not like lemon lime kind of thing. So I always try and find the combinations that don't have that in them, which is very hard. So this one we like, the cherry limeade peach. This has blackberry lemonade. This one's pretty good. And then this is a new one from LaCroix, which I thought looked, it's not really for me, so. But this is guava, beach plum, and black well, it says raspberry. So even though black raspberries do not exist. So is it a blackberry and a raspberry and they had a baby? I don't really know. Hopefully this will last us for a while. Okay, moving on to the box. Usually buy little pre-cut carrots and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna buy the real carrots, my favorite vegetable, and we're gonna wash them, chop them up, and do put in a little bit of work. They're a lot more affordable for the price. I think they're like $4 for 6 pounds, whereas the equivalent little pre-cut mini carrots are like $6 for 4 pounds or something, I don't know. Then we have some Better Than Bouillon vegetable broth kind of base. I really like this because you have the base already made for you, and then you just add hot water and you make your own veggie stock, which is really helpful. When I feel like things are tasteless and like they're missing some kind of broth, I just haven't got it together to make my own. These, I've never tried these. I'm always, as I said, snacks are my nemesis. I'm always looking for things that are healthier than just the regular garbage that we feed our kids all the time, not us personally, society. This, look, they're again, not gonna be as good as if you make them on your own, but I don't think this is terrible. If I look, I can recognize all of these ingredients, and I have all of these ingredients in my house besides butternut squash, so I could probably make these, but yeah, this is a gift. Again, this is a gift to myself, otherwise I have to make something. Because they need snacks. Like, my daughter is required to bring 2 separate snacks for school every day. So not only does she need lunch, she needs 2 separate snacks that can't be too messy, don't need refrigeration ideally, have to be nut-free. I don't want them full of sugar. I don't want packaged garbage. So this I'll just put into little bags, and then we'll see if they like them. Baked snack crackers, cheddar flavor. They're made with red beans and butternut squash. So we'll see. We'll see if my 2-year-old likes them. Do you like them? Mm-hmm. Yeah, wow, yummy. Those look good. Then I always buy avocados from Costco, but they have to be green because obviously, like, I can't eat all of these avocados. These are hard as rocks, and they are going to go in the fridge, and they're going to stay there for the rest of time. No, until we eat them. We go through avocados probably like 2 or 3 a day. My son especially loves avocado toast, and I'm like very happy for him to eat that all day every day. And then they usually have an avocado for dinner, with dinner as like the side, so I always stock up. So I bought 4 bags. Usually sometimes I buy 5, but this time we're doing 4. Okay, got some raspberries. I'm gonna prolong the life of my berries as long as possible with a little bit of salt and baking soda, and that really helps. And then strawberries, same thing. Huge thing, like they'll go bad before we can eat them all. But if you prepare them properly, they last a really long time, like weeks. So I can show you how I do that. So I said I would share how I keep my fruit and vegetables staying fresh for longer, and I'm not going to disappoint you. This method works really well. I've done it a lot. So as you can see, I soaked all of my strawberries, carrots, and raspberries, as it turned out. I put the carrots in first because they're the heaviest. They're going to destroy the raspberries. I soaked them in cold water with a little bit of salt and then vinegar for not very long, and then you take them out, you let them thoroughly dry. The carrots dried really quickly, and I was able to just kind of dry them with the cloth. And then you can see this water, it is nasty, and that's all the stuff that you're taking off. I think the salt draws out some of the moisture, and the vinegar kills the bacteria, which helps them to last for longer. And then the key is to absorb the moisture. So the technique that I have found works really well is you line your dish with a paper towel because it's going to absorb any excess. And then here comes the more time consuming part. You need to remove the stems of the strawberries so they have a nice flat bottom. And then you just layer everything as if you're making a tart. And even though this takes a bit of time up front, your strawberries will last for weeks with this method. So you'll never have to throw away strawberries that you couldn't eat. So I just basically hulled all of these strawberries, put them face down. I don't think I technically hulled them because that's when you remove the leaves without chopping them. And then I just put all of the raspberries on top, put a lid on everything, and we keep it in the fridge. And then as we need berries, fresh berries, we have them because they're so expensive. So to waste them is sacrilege. And then butter, because also lasts forever. Kerrygold Irish butter, it's the best. I got unsalted and salted. Usually I use unsalted for baking, salted sometimes for baking too. Bit of an impulse buy, I bought the kids some socks. I have some other socks, okay. So I bought his and her socks because I think the socks we have right now are garbage, and they're holy at this point. So I bought my son some and my daughter, and maybe they'll never need socks again. That would be wonderful. Avocado oil, organic avocado oil. I always buy this from Costco. I use this as my main oil for like frying, for like high smoke points. I don't use olive oil anymore because I think it's supposed to be more for lower smoke points. It's not supposed to be heated. Okay. Last box. All right, let's just stay on the snack tray for a second. So again, I don't buy these every time, but if you need a grab and go snack, I will usually make something like this, but I know these are nut free and can go to school and they're not super messy and they sort of shelf stable. Is that the right word? They're not gonna become a total mush. So again, buying these really for me, but for the kids, so I don't have to make them right now. More snacks, I guess, these clementines, my daughter loves them, so go through those, and they last forever in the fridge as well, so I'm okay buying a big bag. Oh, another thing of avocados. Ugh, lemons. I do have a lemon tree, but it's going to be many years before this lemon tree gives me lemons. These are the seedless ones, so one less thing I have to worry about, but they also last a long time in the fridge, so this giant bag goes with the avocados. Okay, and then the probably most exciting thing was that I bought these pants. These are gray ones. I have blue from last year, and my cousin actually, when I went to visit her, was wearing this. I could see they were the same, like they were cousin pants, you know, like pants were actually cousins. These are the best if you can get hold of these, especially for like our hot summers here in Texas. You can get a hold of these pants because they're linen, so they're just like, it's nice to not have to wear the same like sweatpants all the time, or short, if you don't want to wear shorts, which often I don't because I don't want my legs to get sunburned, or I don't want to get bitten by mosquitoes, or I just don't want to have my legs, I don't know, showing my legs. But you know, I had to buy, they're on sale, so I had to buy a few more for my mom and for my sister. So I bought some for my sister. Hopefully these will fit them, but yeah, they were $3 off. So they're like $10 at Costco. They're the best. If you see them, at the moment I saw they had them in like a black stripe. I thought this one was the nicest, but they do not have a lot of small sizes. I find in Costco the small sizes sell out so quick. I would usually be like a medium in clothing, just as reference, but in at Costco, if it's like a Costco brand, I don't know, I always feel like the sizes run really big. So I got myself a small. My sister's a little smaller than me, but we got her a small, that's what she wanted, and then we got my mom an extra small, which I know it's like, we would never, like growing up, I would never be a small or extra small, it would not cross my mind, but Costco runs, I've learned my lesson, and there's nowhere to like try them on, I mean, you can return them, but it's a pain in the butt. Okay, so this is everything that I bought from Costco. The beginning of this video, I think I mentioned it was $300. No, it was $396.61. Does that seem like a lot of money for all of this that I just dropped this kind of without planning? I literally went in for avocados, protein powder. What else did I want? Strawberries, carrots, clementines, lemons, like that kind of stuff. But they're all of these staples that we use. I try not to go to Costco more than like once a month. It can be challenging. You know, things are expensive these days. And sometimes it's this toss up of finding the best deals or thinking that you've got a good deal versus like just wasting your money. But anyway, I'm gonna start putting all of this stuff away and prepping a whole bunch of things. And I will see you guys in my next video. Oh, if you enjoyed this is not something I usually do. I'm not really like the haul girl. Let me know, because you know I try and live kind of simply and as clutter-free as possible, but we gotta eat, so this is what we buy. All right, I will see you guys in my next video. Don't forget to subscribe, like this video, and I will see you soon. And if you're here till the end, sorry, I'm so rambly today. I love you so much, big hug. Thank you for being here. You're one of the real ones. Okay, bye. I'm gonna let the sun shine in today. Trying to make this darkness go away.